Well, first of all, thank you, Ovanes, for organizing and inviting me to also give a presentation here. Well, my work is a little bit about some ongoing work I work on once in a while. And well, I thought it would be a nice idea to present some results I got up to now in there. So it's about minimax robust control in differential games, and well, I will first give a little bit of overview why I'm interested in this subject, and well, why how I tackled the problem, and then give some results, particularly for the scalar case. For the scalar case, I succeeded in solving all the problems I will present here. Unfortunately, the extension to the multivariable case is difficult, so I only have partial results there. And well, in the end, we will maybe see some example which illustrates why things are that difficult for solving problems in this area. So and why I'm interested in this stuff? Well, it's mainly because I think many processes are characterized by many players, which affect the process, and there is also uncertainty how the process will evolve in the future. And basically, the players, every player has his own opinion about uncertainty, and he has his own game. And then the question arises, I think, well, how can we mathematically model such processes to some extent? And well, how seems the first shot approach to this problem? Well, first shot approach would be that you assume that the process which you consider can be described by some state variables, and that those state variables evolution can be described by some linear continuous differential equation. Yeah, so the idea is that the x variables describe the state variables of the process you are interested in, and well, assuming that there are n players who can impact on the process, I assume also that they influence then linearly the state variable. And furthermore, I assume that also noise will linearly impact on the state variables. Yeah, so very first shot linear approximation of reality probably, but okay. That's the idea, how I approximate the process. Furthermore, I will assume that the actions that will be used by the players and depend on the current state of the system. Yeah, so I assume that all players will just use a linear feedback of the system. And another thing I will assume is that the players have a common interest to stabilize the system. Yeah, I think that that makes sense. If you consider, for instance, nowadays problems involved in the ecology, and then well, everyone has his own selfish interest, but in the end, there's also some common interest to steer the process to some values which do not blow up. Okay, Well, I assume moreover and that the objectives of every player is in a noise-free situation. So if the W is not in the process equation, that then the players want to minimize just a linear quadratic cost function. And these kind of cost functions are quite reasonable if you want to steer a process which is out of equilibrium back to its equilibrium. Yeah, if you make a second order approximation of that cost function, then you automatically get towards something which is described as GI over here. So how to deal then with the noise? Well, I assume that instead of the original cost function, and that players will consider a cost function where additionally a quadratic cost is involved for the disturbance, and players would like to consider the worst case outcome of noise in this formulation. Yeah, so instead of considering the original linear quadratic control setting, yeah, I consider an extended linear quadratic control setting where W is the noise and VI describes how serious players expect noise will influence the process. And you see, if I want to maximize this expression with respect to W, then you see that if I take VI very large, and then this term becomes very large. So if you want to have then the maximum of it or the supremum, and then you see it would be optimal to have W equal to zero. Yeah, so the idea is that the larger I take VI, yeah, that models more or less that the player does not expect a large impact of noise. So conversely, the smaller you take VI, the larger impact is expected by the player of the noise term. So basically, I assume now that every player considers the maximum or the supremum of this expression, and then I model the process then that, by the fact that all players will in the end have a Nash equilibrium. Yeah, so I consider for every player I this the supremum of this, and then I consider a Nash equilibrium for all these players together. Yeah, so I formulated it here in a mathematical way. Yeah, so I consider the maximum of W, where I assume that the noise process is just given by an L2 sequence. Yeah, so a quadratically integrable function from 0 to infinity. And well, I call then a set of F1 up to Fn a Nash equilibrium, yeah, if the usual inequality is satisfied. Okay, so if I can find an equilibrium of this kind, then I will call this min-max soft constraint linear feedback Nash equilibrium. Okay, so what is the relationship with previous literature? Well, in fact, Tamer Bassar and Pierre Bernard already considered the one player case for this, and they also considered various information structures there, and they considered in their H-infinity optimal control and related minimax design problems book in 1991 this concept to solve, for instance, the H-Infinity problem. In the multiplayer open loop context, Gabor Kuhn in his PhD did work here, and Bram van den Broek and Hans Schumacher and myself did work on this for the problem I sketched above. And so basically, the linear feedback concept. Okay, so what it will then be new in the results I will present here? Well, first of all, as I already said in the introduction, I will give a complete characterization for the scalar case. So if the process dynamics are just described by one scalar variable, yeah, then I can give a complete solution to the problem. And as I already said, I will also give some results for the multivariable case, but yeah, not unfortunately the both necessary and sufficient conditions. Yeah, I will just be able to give some preliminary sufficient conditions there. And furthermore, I will give some related equilibrium concepts, and then give also characterizations and necessary and sufficient conditions for those equilibria. Okay, so for the one player control problem, there's been also nice applications. For instance, it's related to the disturbance attenuation problem and the H infinity problem, bounded L2 gain problem, and also a modeling risk aversion. And this kind of modeling is used. And also, if you want to model the impact of risk on performance, in case this expression is not positive definite, yeah, still you can interpret it as that the performance in the end will just degrade at most with some constant time the level of the noise that is coming in. Okay, well, in the results I will present, you will see back two equations regularly. And the first one, equation 5, it's a set of coupled Riccati equations. So just remember the numbers. Don't try to read these equations, that doesn't make any sense. And equation 6 will also pop up, and it's just saying that the closed loop system should be stabilized if the ultimate equilibrium actions are used. Yeah, so equation 5 is about coupled Riccati equations. Equation 6 is about the closed loop system that should be stabilized. So what is then the result for the scalar case? Well, we have a minimax soft constraint feedback Nash equilibrium if and only if, and those two equations 5 and 6 have a set of solutions, and these solutions should satisfy an additional property, namely that ACL closed loop matrix plus MJXG, that should be asymptotically stable for every J. And furthermore, either one of next conditions should be satisfied, namely A minus the closed loop system minus SIXJ XY should be asymptotically stable, or this quadratic equation in YI should have a solution. Yeah, so if these conditions 1 and 2, and where either 2i or sub ii is satisfied, then I know that the corresponding fi given by this expression performs linear feedback Nash equilibrium, and conversely, these are also necessary for solving the problem for the scalar case. Okay. For the multivariable case, yeah, I can show that again, yeah, those two equations 5 and 6 must have necessarily a solution, yeah, where again this matrix ACL plus MJ XG should be asymptotically stable too for all J. And furthermore, the second, if one of the second conditions is satisfied, yeah, so the first condition is alone what you saw for the scalar case, the second condition is alone what you saw in the scalar case, and the third sufficient condition is that if the matrix MI is larger than SI, then also I can conclude that there will be a min-max soft constraint linear feedback Nash equilibrium. Yeah, so these two conditions were both necessary and sufficient for the scalar case, yeah, but in general not for the multivariable case. Yeah, there is some gap, and unfortunately I did not wasn't able to close that gap until now. Yeah, so that is some ongoing work to try to have both necessary and sufficient condition here. But yeah, things are tricky. Okay, then some extensions. Well, one could wonder, why would you be interested in finding a min-max equilibrium? Yeah, basically the involved players, and they would just be interested, I think, in the supremum with respect to the external signal coming in, trying to maximize that or to minimize all those suprema, and instead of just minimizing the maximum of it. Yeah? That the supremum can indeed be realized as a maximum, yeah, is probably for the involved players not really something they would be interested in. So you could ask yourself, so can we also solve then the problem if we just consider a min sub problem? Yeah, so instead of considering the max here, I just consider the sub, and then again, yeah, looking for a Nash equilibrium. Okay, for the scalar case again, under some minor restriction, yeah, I can formulate here in easy way both necessary and sufficient conditions for solving the problem. Yeah, again, those equations 5 and 6 should have a solution, and but different from the min-max solution, we have an additional thing here, some matrix ACL plus MIXI should also be stable, but that condition is not here anymore. And these two conditions are the same as you also saw for the max problem. Okay, so that's nice. We can find or even solve that problem for the scalar case. But for the multivariable case, yeah, until now, I only can show that these equations 5, 6 should again have a set of real symmetric solutions. But sufficient conditions, which are more general than those under the min-max condition, I was not able to find them yet, but again, that is ongoing work, and I hope to find something there also in the nearby future. Okay, another extension of the min-max equilibrium concept would be that if you do not require that every player would wants to stabilize the system, but wants to stable, wants to have the property and the closed loop system converges with a rate of at least epsilon. Yeah, so every player has the idea that he wants to steer the closed loop system at least with a rate of epsilon I towards zero. Yeah, and well, can formulate then again the notion of Nash equilibrium for that concept. And again, yeah, for the scalar case, I can give them both necessary and sufficient conditions under which this problem is solvable. Yeah, and you see again two conditions popping up, and where now in a non-linear way this epsilon I is involved. And also over here you see that in fact epsilon I is coming in even quadratically. But again, both necessary and sufficient conditions can be formulated for the scalar case, so that's nice.
I'm sorry, we're a little bit short of time, so maybe
another. Yeah, so I'm almost finished. I also have then a third extension that would be the instead of the min sub, the infimum sub equilibrium concept. Yeah, so if you just consider the infimum instead of the minimum of the sub, yeah, and then you have to refine, of course, the Nash concept a little bit, and so you formulate here an epsilon Nash equilibrium concept. And in that case, yeah, for the one player case, you can also, I could go so far, formulate both necessary and sufficient conditions under which the problem is solvable. And for the multivariable case, if I have that Si is larger than Mi, yeah, then also I'm in business, then I can show that the game has for the one player case Nash equilibrium. And this condition, by the way, what does it mean? That Si is larger than Mi, that means that it is relatively costly to use control to deal with the worst case impact of the disturbance. Okay, so that's basically what I wanted to see. And well, maybe some one final plot illustrating the problems. If you have usually an optimization problem, then you have that the area around which you optimize, it's a nice convex set. But in the problems we have over here, yeah, it may happen that the set over which you optimize is not convex anymore, and so that may make that the minimum which is attained here.
I'm sorry, are you trying to show us the plot or?
Yeah, so this is a plot of
we cannot see it, we still see the PDF file. Maybe you could press button share, share the screen, not a particular application, the whole screen, then we could see.
You have this plot now or not?
Not yet.
Okay. Okay, well,
it's,
anyway.
It's the same way.
Yeah, so the basic problems occur due to the fact that in general the set over which you optimize may not be convex. So it can happen that optima can arise at different parts of the set where you have to optimize, as it is not a convex set anymore. So that makes the analysis much more troublesome. So the basic message I wanted to tell you. Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks for your attention.
Thank you very much for the presentation. Anyone has any questions? for this topic. Okay, then I will ask, could you please comment, how do you realize a common interest of stabilizing? At the very beginning, you said that so each player has his own cost function or objective function, and then there is another general interest of optimizing the or stabilizing. So stabilizing. How it is exactly realized in the strategies? Maybe I did not see the point. If you could.
Well, you see that they players have to stabilize the whole system, so that makes that you are looking just for strategies in the end, which all together in the end stabilize the system. And also, if you consider, for instance, an application. I studied an application in a fishing area. Then you see that this requirement makes that some players should behave, say, like governments, whereas other players, the other players can behave more individually. Yeah, but this assumption makes that at least that there should be one player who takes care of that condition, that the in the end the system will be stabilized. Yeah, so there should be some player which takes care of the whole system, that it is stabilized.
Okay, thank you very much.